channel. Today's video is a highly requested one, and it is all of my pregnancy favorites. And I'm currently very deep into my third trimester, so I'm getting very close here. I've got just a couple more weeks to go until baby girl's arrival. So I feel like it's a really good time for me to round up all of the things that have made pregnancy a little bit easier, products I've been loving, clothing items, because I've gone through quite a few things and found what works for me, what doesn't. So hopefully you guys can find some things that might be helpful to you as well. As you know, pregnancy is kind of, you know, a journey. The first trimester I was really sick and just not feeling well at all. The second trimester, it was like the clouds parted. I felt amazing and had a lot more energy. And now that I'm in the third trimester, I'm starting to slow down a little bit. So there's definitely been some things that I found along the way that have made the process a bit easier. And certain things I'm gonna show you, like my pregnancy pillow. I went through like three to get to the right ones. So I really just wanted to create this video so that it's hopefully helpful to some of you out there who are either expecting, planning to be expecting, or have already had kids, but maybe you might be doing it again. So a lot of these things are also great pregnant or not. I have some nutrition favorites in here. I have some clothing favorites. You might find something that you just think is a great fit for you, regardless of whether or not you are expecting. So yeah, I have quite a few items, so let's just go ahead and get into it so this video isn't like 2 hours long. It still might be though, warning. And I will link everything down below. I don't know like the official names of every single product, so I will accurately link everything below if I either don't say the name wrong, or don't know the name at all, so you guys can find them easily because I am gonna be zipping through quite a few things, so just check below if I skip over something. So I'll go ahead and get started with clothing items because I think that this is something that has been kind of hit or miss for me. When you become pregnant, like there's so many new things you have to think about. And as your body's growing and changing, things that worked for you last month may not be working for you this month, and your needs are constantly evolving. So I found a few items that have been really great staples throughout most of the entire pregnancy, and I thought they'd be great to share with you here. So I'll start with undergarments. And the thing about bras when you're pregnant, you've got a few things going on. One, your boobs are growing. They're massive compared to normal, at least in my case. And in the first trimester, they're really, really sore. And then as you grow, your belly's expanding, so your kind of like band area here needs to become bigger. You don't really want wires or anything that digs in, but you need more support than ever. So I found a few bras that have been just like game-changing for me, and I love them. So the first one is a totally soft cut bra, and these are just great for casual days. This is a Cosabella bra, and as you can see, there's no wires. It's a really soft, buttery fabric. This is a super stretchy band. So that was really important to me because a lot of bands, while they're stretchy, they're not like as stretchy as this, where it's not gonna be uncomfortable and like digging into your rib area where you're growing and you've got this baby kind of pushing everything up. This is just such a comfortable band. I've got so much room to grow that I really haven't had to go up in size the entire pregnancy. I also have it in nude, and I have a medium in this, and I've been wearing these for several months, and I think that I could get a lot more longevity out of this, even if I were to get bigger. These are really great, just beautiful soft cut bras. They have great support, but they feel like nothing on. I've been wearing them like daily. They're just so, so comfortable, and I love them. Another bra that I love when I need a little bit more support, or if I'm wearing a shirt like this that's more sheer, I'm actually wearing one of these bras right now. This is by the brand Wacol. This is also a wireless bra, but it's definitely a little bit more shapely. So it's kind of got this soft cup to it. And this is great, like, okay, these bras will show some nib. So like, this is just a very sheer, almost like buttery t-shirt style bra. This has a little bit more molding and a little bit more support. It has some boning on the sides. So this is great when I'm wearing like tight dresses, tight shirts, anything form-fitting where I really want that smooth shaping effect. It's wireless, they're super flexible, super soft fabric, and they're just a great alternative to like a classic underwire bra that you just really don't wanna be wearing right now, especially later in my pregnancy. Like I can't even imagine wearing a really tight, wired, constricting bra and in the heat. So this has just been a great alternative when I need that extra support and shape, but I really don't want to feel uncomfortable. This next one is more of like a sleep and lounge bra, and this is just a Calvin Klein sports bra. I've been living in these in multiple colors. I also have a medium in this. This is also a very stretchy band, but I've noticed when I'm kind of hanging out and lounging around the house, I really don't love having something on my belly all the time. Sometimes having a shirt over my belly is actually really uncomfortable. I get itchy, I get hot. And when I'm loading up like body butters and oils, sometimes I really want to let my belly breathe so that it can all sink in before I'm putting on a shirt and then I feel like it's all sticky. So these have been great and they're kind of just like a half shirt. They feel just sort of like a crop top, but they let the belly free. They're super affordable. There's nothing to them in terms of like structure. So they're just really comfortable and breathable, thin cotton. I get these on like Amazon. I've noticed at night, and I've never ever in my life been someone that would ever think I would sleep in a bra because the thought of that would have been so uncomfortable to me. But now that my boobs are like twice the size as they were before, it's actually more comfortable to sleep in a bra because I feel more secure. Like when I'm laying on my side, I'm just more comfortable having that support. So I sleep in these a ton because they're just so easy to throw on, so soft, so comfortable. You can't even feel them. And I don't really care about them because they're so affordable that like I can get all of my creams and lotions and oils on them. They're very casual, they're replaceable. So they're great. I highly recommend just grabbing a few of these if you're pregnant because you never know when you're just gonna wanna throw something on and not have like anything tight over your belly. And these have been great. And they give me enough coverage too, where when I'm walking around the house, I don't feel like uncomfortable in these. They're not like a bra. They're more of like a half tank top. So I love these. Similar to the sports bra, I've been loving these boxer shorts. And I have to say, these are men's. So these are actually my husband's. Let me see what size he is. It's pretty washed off and faded. I can't even see it anymore. It's like gone. These are his boxers. And when I was sleeping before pregnant, I would always wear like pants, like a pants and top set type of thing. I was really comfortable wearing pants. I put lotion on at night and I don't like it getting all over my sheets. So I typically wear pants. My husband likes it so cold in our room, like 68 at night. So I'm usually someone that runs really cold, but during pregnancy, I've been running so hot. Like I wake up drenched in the night, sweating. You can't make it cold enough for me in the room. I will still get hot in the night. So I've switched over to shorts, and all of the shorts that I owned pre-pregnancy for sleep were like sexy shorts. So they were like cute little booty shorts that just were not gonna fit me now, especially with the belly, like it's just not happening. They like cover one of my butt cheeks. So I really needed shorts in a pinch, so I grabbed my husband's boxer briefs. And I love them. I actually took a whole stack of them out of his drawer and I sleep in these almost every single night. And the reason that I love the men's for this is because the way a men's body is, it's a little bit more straight. So this waistband really accommodates the belly. It's not tapered in like a woman's short. So it really has enough room for the belly. But because these are so elastic and short and they're meant to like really fit a man, they fit my legs really well. They're tight enough here, but wide enough up here, where a lot of women's shorts are just too tight up here if I want to get the size that fits my legs. It's too small on my legs. So these are great because they're just more of a straight fit, so they really accommodate the belly. They're super comfortable. And oddly enough, my husband finds these very sexy. Like when I wear his shorts, he's like, wow, those are so sexy. So, I mean, I don't know. Maybe he's just trying to make me feel good. Don't take my word for it. If your man doesn't find this sexy, like don't come for me, but he says that it's very cute. So this paired with my little sports bra at night has kind of been my sleeping go-to. And I just love this combo. It's super comfortable. My final undergarment is a Bella band. So these are amazing because it's just a band that goes from like right underneath your bra line to the bottom of your belly. So I've been loving these. I also have one in white and I wear them with any sort of tops that are a little bit too short for me, a little bit cropped. It's helped me wear a lot of my cropped sort of like sweatshirts and things with one of these under it and sweatpants. When I want coverage on my belly, like there's a fine line for me. Sometimes showing a little bit of belly is cute and sometimes it just looks not right. Like your little belly is just hanging out. Like it's not an attractive look. I've been loving these for anything that's not quite long enough on me anymore. It's helped me get a lot more longevity out of some of my pre-pregnancy pieces. And I can't pull this off anymore, but in the beginning of my pregnancy, like the first 4 to 5 months, I was actually able to hold a lot of my jeans and shorts together. If I would just unbutton them, that they didn't fit anymore, but they still fit everywhere else, I would just put this over my belly and over the top band of the pants to hold it together. So I'd zip them up and not button it. And this would kind of hold them in place. So these are great. They'll really help you get more wear out of your pre-pregnancy pants for a much longer. So if you're newly pregnant, I highly recommend investing in at least a black one. I got white as well because I wear a lot of white tops, white sweatshirts, white crops. So these are great too. I also wear these for working out a lot. If I'm kind of wearing like a little sports bra, sometimes I'll just put this on and then put my leggings on. It almost looks like a full tank top. So these are great. They're kind of multifunctional. They do give you great support. So I could see myself wearing this post-pregnancy. before I'm ready to wear any of those like really constricting, tight, like binding things, this would just be a great, nice thing to kind of suck you in. I could see wearing this home from the hospital when you feel like your organs are all out of place after labor and you just want something to feel a little bit more contained and supported. This would be like a great thing for that. So I may actually throw this in my hospital bag. And then in terms of workout clothes, I used to teach yoga in college, and that was like when Lululemon was in its heyday, and I was such a Lulu girl. I was all about like the Wonder Underpants, and I would like go to Lulu weekly and try to like grab the new color that they had out. Since then, I really shifted over to brands like Aloe. I don't really shop at Lulu anymore, but when I found out I was pregnant, a lot of the Aloe pants are just really tight on me in the band, and I wanted something that was a little bit more soft and flexible. So I discovered these Lululemon Align pants, and I'm so late to this party because I've always been a Wonder Under girl. I've never tried the Align, but this fabric is just insane. I know that they have several fabrics, so I'll list below which one I got, but it's so soft, so stretchy. These feel like nothing on. Like, they're not tight, constricting leggings. They're literally just so stretchy and buttery. I just love them. Like, I feel so comfortable in these. So I got these in a few different colors, and I always get the high-waisted. And the thing about high-waisted, so I actually don't like a lot of the maternity workout leggings that go over the belly. I feel like when I'm hot and I'm sweating and I'm working out, like, it just gets kind of gross. And I also feel like they kind of slide down a lot, so I actually get the high-waisted in these Lulus so I can fold them down as low as I want and just let the belly not be kind of like covered up by some big band. I feel more comfortable that way. I use my tank top to cover the belly. So the great thing about this is they're so flexible that when you roll them down, like, you don't feel this really tight band digging into your low hip bones. Like, it just folds super nicely and sits there. These are great. And then along those lines, this tank from Lulu, it's just a basic black racer back tank, but it's the same material as the Align pants, and it's so, so stretchy. I got this in a 4, and that's like my pre-pregnancy size. I've really tried to get as many things as possible in my pre-pregnancy size, just knowing that there's only like a few months that you're gonna be wearing these things, and then you're probably gonna try to go back to your previous sizes. So anything that I can make work in my previous size that just has some extra stretch and give, I'm all about. And this is one of those things. I have it in black and white. I have multiples of them because I just constantly wear them. Goes with everything, matches all my workout pants, but they're just so comfortable and they're not overly constricting or tight. And then one more tank that you can wear for working out, or I wear these with sweatpants a lot, like cute sweatpants and like really cute little slides or something, as just sort of like a daily casual outfit, is this maternity tank, and it's by the brand Ingrid and Isabel. And this is amazing because it's so stretchy, but it's nice and long, so it fully covers the belly. And what I love about this is it doesn't stain. It's weird, like, I could literally be dripping in oil because I'm using so many stretch mark creams and oils, and it doesn't stain. So it's just great because it's so stretchy. You only need one your entire pregnancy. This might even be like one size fits all, but I got a few of them because I just wear them all the time. It's like my go-to everyday shirt. It looks super cute with like cute necklaces and a little bun and just like this little tank, black sweatpants, cute little slides, and you're like good to go. So this has been super easy, very much on heavy rotation. And then the final piece I'll show you is like more to talk about a brand because I have so many pieces from this brand. So I'll just show you one piece, but I've been wearing these like mostly to go out anytime I've got like a fun occasion, a date night. Not that I've been going out much at all, but they're great because you can dress them down for day and just like throw a little cardigan over, little flats, little slides, or you can do heels, boots for night. But these are bump suits. And this is an off the shoulder style called the Harper, but it's gonna be hard to show you this on camera. And I'm already out of breath if you can tell. This is like pathetic, but talking gets me out of breath at this point. But it's just one big piece. It's a super soft, buttery fabric, super stretchy. You're supposed to order your pre-pregnancy size, so these are cut and fit for pregnancy to account for the belly and fit everywhere else. But I love these. They're so chic. They're one piece. If you have to pee, it's not like a romper where you've got a like whole situation of unbuttoning, zipping. You literally just pull it down, pull it back up. They're so flattering, so sexy. When you're pregnant, as you know, if you are pregnant, it's really frustrating sometimes to get dressed. Like, your body's changing so much. You're like, you know, much bigger than you were before. And it can be a little bit defeating when you're just trying to get dressed to like go out with your husband or do something and you you want to feel cute and like nothing's fitting, you're squeezing into everything, you're sweating, you're just like not in a good place. And so these have been like the answer for those moments when I'm just like, what do I wear? I don't have to think of two pieces, a top and bottom. I think of one item, throw it on, it always looks great. So I love these, and this is not sponsored at all. I buy these with my own money. But the founder, Nicole, reached out on Instagram when I tagged them and offered my followers a discount. I think it's 15% off, so I'll leave the code below. But if you're interested, I highly recommend bump suits. Like, these have saved my pregnancy. I bought a few of them at the beginning of my pregnancy, and I've been wearing them the whole way through. And I really don't need anything else for like day and nighttime. They're just so versatile. If you go to their site, you'll see all the styles that they have, but you can wear them so many multiple ways, and they're fabulous. They also wash really, really well. Like, there's no pilling, no fading. They hold up super well, and mine still look like new, and I've worn them dozens and dozens of times. So highly recommend. Okay, now I'm gonna talk to you about supplements and nutrition favorites. And this is really important for me because I am plant-based. I've been plant-based this entire pregnancy. I don't consider myself vegan, and I'll explain why. I have two non-vegan supplements here, but I don't eat meat, chicken, turkey, fish, dairy, and I have been following a predominantly vegan diet during this pregnancy. So it's been really important to me to make sure that I'm getting all of my nutrients and everything I need to support this baby. So when I first found out I was pregnant, I began working with a prenatal nutritionist just to make sure that with my diet and, you know, cutting out a lot of animal products, I was still able to cover my bases, include enough variety, and understand the types of nutrients that I could be lacking and where I could get them from plant-based sources. So the first thing I'll talk about is my prenatal vitamin. And this is the Thorne Basic Prenatal. This was recommended by my nutritionist. And leading up to this, I was using the Ritual Prenatal. And she said that that one was fine, but for my specific needs, she said that this one was more complete. You do take three of these a day. So what I do is I just keep this in the kitchen, right on a ledge in the pantry, and with every meal I just have one. I love this because I never get an aftertaste, I don't taste it later, and I initially thought, oh, taking like three a day with each meal, that's gonna be a chore. But by keeping it in the kitchen, it's so habitual for me. It's like when I grab my meal, I just grab my prenatal. Like, I just, it's right there. I know I'm supposed to take it. It's no big deal. I never miss it anymore. So this has been great. I've really been liking it. It's super gentle on my stomach. It does have iron and some things that a lot of prenatals don't. So I've really been having a great time with this, and all of my blood work has been very good. I highly recommend this if you're looking for a great prenatal that has a lot of things, or if you're vegetarian or vegan and looking for something that's super complete, this is a great one. This next one is a newer one for me because I have evaded heartburn my entire pregnancy up until the last few weeks. And as someone that like tends to seek out natural remedies and always looking for alternatives to like conventional medications, I've tried like everything you can for heartburn that's recommended online, and nothing really worked for me. And it's like a weird thing that happens. I don't experience it all day, and then when I lay down at night, the laying down part, like, it's like all of this acid just comes up my throat and I'm like breathing fire. It doesn't matter how early I eat. Like, if I eat dinner at 5, I'll still have heartburn at like 11. It's just really uncomfortable. So the only thing that's been working that I borrowed from like our family downstairs like medicine cabinet, and I don't know like who in the house had this, but I'm so glad that they did, is this Pepcid Complete. And I'm not proud of this. It definitely has like some artificial stuff in here, but it works. And when you're super uncomfortable, like, you have to just give yourself a break. Like, you know, nothing was working for me, and this was keeping me up all night. And this is a tablet form, and you're just supposed to take one in 24 hours, so you don't take much of it. But literally the minute I chew it, which, by the way, they taste pretty good. Like, I'm sure it's aspartame or some crap, but it's a berry flavor, and these are good. Like, they taste like candy, but they're like these little tiny tablets, and I swear, the second that like this hits your throat, you're better. Like, it completely takes away heartburn for me. So, you know, it's getting me through. If you're suffering from heartburn and you've tried everything and nothing's really seeming to work, pick up some Pepcid. I know it's not like the best thing in the world, but it's definitely effective. And for me, with all of the little discomforts in the night of pregnancy between not being able to sleep, restless legs, getting up to pee so many times, and now heartburn, I will take whatever I can to just like get some sleep. So this has been great, and I do recommend it if you're having trouble finding something that works. So this next one is general, and then I'll show you what I put in it. So generally, smoothies have been a huge pregnancy favorite for me, like from the moment I found out I was pregnant. So my first trimester was really rough. Like I was throwing up multiple times a day, like 3-4 times a day. There was a couple times I projectile vomited, like while having a conversation with my husband, like on the floor. I mean, it was awful. Like I have never felt so sick in my life, and I do not wish it on anybody. But keeping food down was really hard, and even wanting to eat or like finding anything that was remotely appetizing was really hard for me. And the only thing that sounded good and still just sounds so amazing is cold smoothies. I was always an oatmeal person for breakfast, but the minute I became pregnant, like anything warm in the morning was just like repulsive to me. Cooked oats was like disgusting. Anything cold and creamy and refreshing was just like so good sounding to me. And it still is. So smoothies have been amazing because they're such an easy way to throw a lot of really nutritious things in, but they taste so good when you add fruits and all sorts of different blends. So I feel like it's a great way to sneak in a lot of those things that you're trying to get on a daily basis during pregnancy. And for me, I have a few of those things here, and I'll show you what's important for me. One of the things that I've been using a lot of is spirulina. And this is amazing because it's so rich in amino acids. One teaspoon has 2 grams of protein. That's just a teaspoon. And I usually use like a big scoop. 8% of your daily value of iron, 220% of your daily value of vitamin A, 190% of your B12. And as someone who doesn't eat animal products, that's like very, very important to me to make sure I'm getting enough B12. And it is in my prenatal, but getting anything through food sources is always ideal. It's a complete protein, so it has all of the amino acids, which a lot of people, if you're plant-based, will tell you that, you know, plant sources aren't complete proteins. That's a lie. There's lots of complete proteins, and this is one of them. So I've been throwing this in my smoothies. I can't taste it once I add all the fruits and everything else, and it's just a great way to get a lot of nutrition in a really small package, and it's super nutrient dense. The next one is a plant-based protein powder, and this one I found online. It's called Earth Chimp. It's the vanilla flavor. I'm a vanilla protein person. I don't love chocolate protein, but I love this. And the reason I love this, there's no like stevia or kind of like sugar replacements. It's sweetened with a fruit and veg blend, which is date, banana, strawberry, beet, kale, and spinach. The organic protein blend is pea, pumpkin, coconut, and sunflower, which I like because a lot of these proteins can be just one type and it's super concentrated. And to me, that can be a little bit hard to digest. And I also like getting variety in the protein sources to just like round out the amino acid profile and make sure that you're getting a few different things. So I love this. It's just, it also has probiotics and digestive enzymes, but it just tastes great. It mixes in really well. It's been great on my tummy, and I really like just how clean the ingredients are. It says no added sugar, salt, erythritol, gums, gluten, dairy, or GMO. And it's a small vegan business. So I always love things when I can find them made by, you know, smaller companies or, you know, small startup entrepreneurs, because it's always kind of where you find these unique specialty products that are usually really, really awesome. So I got this on Amazon. I'll link it below, but I'll definitely be repurchasing this. It's a great protein. This next one is hemp hearts, and I love these because they're so rich in omega fatty acids, and they're also really rich in iron. And as someone that's eating plant-based, getting enough iron is really important. And when you're pregnant, you also have like 3 times the amount of blood volume, so you really need a lot more iron to support that much more blood. In one serving of this, this has 20% of your daily value of iron, 25% of your thiamine, 100% manganese, 45% magnesium, which is great if you've got any cramping going on, muscle cramps, leg cramps. It's also super rich in protein. One serving has 10 grams of protein, really healthy fats. So I just love these. It has omega-3s and 6s, which are great for the baby's brain development. I just throw them in my smoothies. I sprinkle them on salads, and I love them. They have a really nice nutty flavor. So these next two are not vegan, and I include them because it just makes me feel good. It's an easier way to get these things. You certainly can get them through plant-based sources, but I just prefer taking them this way. This first one is fish oil. So I throw this in my smoothies. This is not something I would have any other way. Like, I wouldn't be sipping this from the capful, like just as a supplement. I wouldn't be like putting this in salad dressing. The only way I can really get this down is like in a smoothie. So I just throw a little bit in there, usually like a tablespoon or two every day, and it just is a great way to get your omega-3s and your DHA and your EPA. You can get this through plant-based sources. There's algae sources. For me personally, I just feel like this is more bioavailable for me and I like taking it this way. I'm someone that was consuming fish before becoming pregnant until I found out at my last annual physical that my mercury was really high. So this is a purified fish oil. It's a great way to get all the benefits of fish without mercury toxicity. Because when I did become pregnant, I didn't want to bring fish back and risk my numbers going back up. So I include this in my smoothie every day. Super easy, can't taste it, and it's a great way to get your omega-3s. This next one is also an animal-based supplement, and this is collagen. This is a grass-fed and pasture-raised unflavored collagen. This also is super rich in protein. One serving has 12 grams of protein, and I throw this in my smoothies. I love this because it's completely unflavored. It's like invisible. You don't know it's in anything. I've even put this in like iced coffee and drink it, and you can't remotely taste it, which I love. So this is great. It has lots of amino acids, and the one that was important that my nutritionist recommended and why I started taking collagen was glycine. She said it's really tough to get on a plant-based diet, and I don't eat eggs, so this has been a great way to get my glycine, and I just don't taste it. It's like it's not even there, so I love this, and if you're somebody that doesn't really want to consume animal products, but you want some of the benefits of the amino acid profile, this is a great way to like take it, but not really notice it at all. You can mix this into lots of things. I typically do it in my smoothies, but I have done it in coffee. You can do it in any sort of beverage, and you just won't know it's there. This next one is sort of a duo, but they both have benefits on their own, and this is these almond butter packs and dates. So this is like my go-to snack, is having dates with almond butter. It's like addicting, you guys. It's such a good snack. But the reason that I love these almond butter packs and I always just have a few in my purse is they make a great snack. When you're pregnant, you get hungry like at unexpected times, but it's also really hard to eat a ton at meal times because your stomach's like pushed up to your chest. The baby's taking up so much space, you really can't fit that much food in anymore. So this is a great snack because it's packed with protein and fats in such a small package. One serving has 7 grams of protein, 4 grams of fiber, which keeps you full, and 15 grams of fat. So it's really satiating. I usually reach for this over something that's like not gonna hold me over as long, like something more carby or just like a piece of fruit. I typically grab something like this because it just doesn't make me hungry. It's a great package to have on the go, like in my purse if I need something quick. And then often I'll have it with dates. And dates are so amazing because they are so rich in minerals. So they have double the amount of potassium and magnesium than bananas do. And like I said, when you're pregnant, you get like restless leg syndrome, leg cramps, muscle aches. So magnesium is really great for that. It's just great for balancing your electrolytes. They're a great sweet treat. So they give you a nice hit of energy from the natural sugars. And there's also lots of data to support that this is like really good for prepping for labor, that dates like ripen your cervix or something. So I don't know about that. We'll see. I'll report back after labor. But this has just been a great go-to snack when I have a little bit of a sweet tooth. I need a quick hit of energy. It's really, really good with the almond butter. It's a great complete snack. You get your protein, your fat, and your carbs. And I've just been loving them during pregnancy. So highly recommend dates. This last one is flaxseed, and I just get these little packs, and I get them on Amazon, but I just cut open the top and put it in my smoothie. It's a single serving pack. They're also great to have on the go, like when I'm going into the hospital, I'll probably take a few, just so that like if I get oatmeal or something for breakfast, I can sprinkle it in. They're just great because they have omega-3 fatty acids, they have protein, but they're just also great at helping you stay regular, which is something during pregnancy that's really up and down. Like, your intestines and your stomach are like completely moved up, your organs are all over the place, and there's actually a hormonal thing that happens when you are pregnant. You create this hormone called relaxin, and that's actually meant to prep you for labor, so it relaxes the muscles in your body. That's why you're more injury prone when you're pregnant, because your joints and your ligaments are a lot looser to allow your hips to open up so that the baby can come out. And relaxin also affects your digestive tract, so everything slows down, you can be a little bit more sluggish, and it's not in your head, it's a real thing that your like hormones are actually causing. So this is a great way to just like boost your fiber in things, sprinkle it on salads, throw it in smoothies, throw it in oatmeal, but just to kind of like increase your fiber and keep things moving. So I've been having this all pregnancy, and these single serving packets are great because you don't have to measure it out. You can just grab them out of the drawer, cut it, sprinkle it on whatever, and know that I'm getting a full serving. So I love these, they've been really, really helpful. Okay, now I'm gonna move on to like creature comforts. And these are things that I just have kept around the house that have been really awesome. And one of these is my pregnancy pillow, and this is gonna be hard to show you guys because it's so massive, so I'll like hold it up here just to kind of give you an idea. It has It has a top and a bottom, so it's not a U one. There is a beginning and an end. I got this on Amazon. It's pretty bulky. It's a full body pillow, but I love this. I'll link it below. And let me explain to you why I like this one. So I've gone through three now. This was the third one that I purchased. The first two were the U shapes. And I've learned I don't like the U shape. I like a body pillow that has a top and a bottom. And there's two reasons for that. One is, at night, I like sleeping with my head on my own pillow. I'm very particular about the pillows that I sleep on. My husband has his set, I have my set, I like a medium firm. But the U-shaped pillows, you kind of nestle in and you have to put your head on that pillow. It's hard to put your own pillow on top because then you're really high. So you kind of have to give up using your own pillows when you use a U-shaped pillow, and I've learned that's just not for me. I like using my own head pillows. And the second reason is, as pregnancy progressed, I started getting up so many times in the night, and when you've got the U shape, you've got one end on each side of you, so it's really hard to roll out of bed. And I'm someone that kind of rolls to the side and pushes myself up with my arms because you can't really use your ab muscles anymore. So having that other side of the pillow to kind of hop over is really annoying to me, where when I don't have both sides and there's an open side, I can just roll straight out of bed and come straight back in and re-hug the pillow. So I just find it's much more easy logistically to get in and out of bed with just one-sided pillow. So I love this one because it's very firm, but still really squishy and soft. So it's not like gonna completely deflate in the night as you're holding it and become like a really like limp sack of pillow. Like, it's got some foam in here that's got some nice bounce back. So it kind of like forms to your body and sinks in where you want it to, but stays firm and still supports you throughout the entire night. It says Cool Flow on it. I don't know if that's like because it's supposed to be cooling. I haven't noticed anything like that, but maybe. But I just really like it. I got it on Amazon, and I've just found that for me personally, the U-shapes just aren't my journey. This is such a better pillow for my needs. So if you're someone that hasn't been able to find a pillow that works for you, and all of the common pregnancy pillows that have good ratings, you're like, why don't I like this? I was like that too until I found something like this. So definitely give it a try. It's worked really well for me. And this next one is a heat pad, and I have like 8 of these. I literally have this in the bathroom so that when I'm doing my makeup, I can put it on the back of my chair. I have it downstairs, so when I'm eating breakfast, I put it on the back of my chair. I have one by my bed, in my office. Like, I love these so much, you guys. And I think what it is it's just really comforting and soothing to me. There's a lot of pressure on your low back during pregnancy, and just having that warmth to sort of relax me and kind of sink into just feels so good when I'm sitting in chairs. So I love this. I'm gonna pack it in my hospital bag because I can imagine that when I'm laying there after labor, it's gonna feel so nice to just have that soothing heat and that warmth on my back. Definitely taking this with me, but if you're starting to feel some of those aches and pains as your belly is growing, I recommend keeping a heating pad around because it really is soothing. Okay, now we're gonna go into some beauty favorites. And I did a whole video dedicated to my skincare pregnancy routine. So I'm just gonna link that below because I don't wanna be redundant and talk about like all the same products. But I will go through kind of like what I've been using for stretch marks and things because that's very specific to pregnancy and that's more body care and some makeup. So the first one I'm gonna talk about is this African Botanics Stretch Mark Botanical Oil. And this is a very luxurious oil. It's definitely on the pricier side, but I just have been feeling like pampering myself during this pregnancy, obviously during the pandemic and being home. I've had a lot more time for self-care and kind of like at-home spa moments, and this definitely like has that beautiful herbal smell that like transforms your bathroom into a spa. It's a very rich, nourishing oil, and I love it. I was reading about this before purchasing it, and it talked about the different types of oils in here and how rich they are in omega fats that are very nourishing and support skin elasticity. So I've been loving this oil. I also really like the pump because when you pump this out, it like projects onto your hand versus like dripping down. I've had a lot of really messy oils, and this one's just really easy to put directly on your body or in your hand. It's a great oil, and I really, really love this. On the other end of the price spectrum is this Jason Vitamin E oil, and I just got this at Whole Foods, but when I found out I was pregnant, I read a lot about vitamin E, and it's obviously used for healing scars and like skin regeneration, and so it's been shown to be really effective for stretch marks in areas of the skin that have been stretched and pulled and cracked. So I thought this would be a great preventative oil to incorporate into a lot of the other oils that I'm applying, mix into my butters and things, body creams. So I've just been using this throughout my entire pregnancy and kind of coupling it up with this oil, any lotion, any cream I'm putting on, just to add that vitamin E boost into it, and I've been loving it. It's super affordable. You can get it even on Amazon. You don't need to get this brand. This is just the brand that they had at Whole Foods, but you can get it pretty much anywhere. This next one is a duo, and this is the Mamma Mio Tummy Rub Oil and the Tummy Rub Butter. And I love this combination. This is what I use most days for daytime because it's very lightweight, but still super hydrating. So if I need to put clothes on, I don't have to feel super sticky. This is definitely like a richer oil, and I will actually put a few drops of this into this butter when I'm applying it. I love this combination for daytime. It's like a not oily oil. Again, this has a really great pump system. So when you pump it out, it projects versus like dripping and getting disgusting. And I actually put this on before the butter, just because I like the way the butter kind of seals this in and removes some of the oiliness. So I put this all over my belly, rub it in, and then I take this butter. And one thing I have found with a lot of body butters, like I was using the Burt's Bees Mama Bee one, I had like a really rich shea butter one. They just are so hard to rub in and absorb. They stay like really white on your skin for a long time. And this one is not like that. So it looks really thick, but if you rub it in, I use kind of a lot, but you can see it just like rubs in super duper well. So it just like, it's very absorbable, I guess you would say. It's not like a thick waxy cream. It's a very nice daytime cream. So I've been loving that combination. It's been really, really great for me. And I do wanna say, guys, before like you go out and purchase all these products, I just wanna preface that I'm not claiming that these have prevented me having stretch marks. I'm very happy to report that I have not experienced stretch marks, but I also think there's a largely genetic component to stretch marks. My mom did not have stretch marks. No women in my family have had stretch marks. So I don't wanna say like, if you go purchase these products, they'll save you from stretch marks because they saved me. I just don't know if that's the case. So just take it with a grain of salt and do what works for you. And just know that sometimes stretch marks are just part of the journey. It's unfortunate, it's not ideal. It's not like we get pregnant and say we can't wait to get our stretch marks, but at the same time, it's all for good things. So don't beat yourself up if you start getting them and get all down on yourself or your body or like that you haven't been applying the right products. Sometimes you can do everything in the world and still get them. So yeah, don't go out and like spend all this money and buy all these things just because I'm saying that they helped me not get stretch marks. I'm not saying that. I'm saying they've been great for me to feel good and have peace of mind to do something preventative, but I don't know if they have effectively kept my stretch marks away, but they just feel great on my skin and I've been loving them. Okay, and finally, I wanna talk about some makeup. And I obviously have my brand Flawless. I'm gonna mention a lot of my products, but generally I just wanted to talk about clean makeup, and that's been a huge thing for me during pregnancy. And it's been a really amazing opportunity for me to reflect on how much emphasis I put on the ingredients in my skincare and really start to think about my makeup way more like skincare. Because the same way that your serums, your creams, and all the things that you put on at night and in the morning to your skin sit on your face, so does your makeup. And that was actually like why I started my brand a few years ago, was I was like, why am I putting all the ingredients that I'm trying to avoid in my skincare back on my skin 5 minutes later in my makeup? Like, that just does not make sense. So one of the biggest things that I've been using nonstop is this Set the Stage Priming Serum. It's a hydrating priming serum, and this has replaced most of my serums. In the morning, I just cleanse, tone, put this on as my serum and moisturizer and primer, and just go straight in with makeup. And the foundation that I use is this Woke Up Like This one, because it's silicone-free, isodotocane-free, paraben-free, mineral oil-free. But I've just been like so conscious more than ever of what's in my makeup. And I wasn't using all clean makeup before pregnancy because I still have some favorites that are conventional that I don't make yet. Like, I don't make an eyebrow pencil yet. I don't make a mascara yet. And I haven't found clean ones that I love. But I did cut out all of my conventional ones when I found out I was pregnant, because I'm just really being conscious about ingredients. So I guess I just wanna mention clean makeup in general, because it's been a huge thing for me during pregnancy, as I'm really conscious of everything I'm consuming. And it's made me really reflect on, like, the minute you find out you're pregnant, you go and remove all these things from your diet, you start taking supplements, you take great care of yourself, you make sure you're hydrated, you cut out all these ingredients in body care, home products, makeup, skincare. But like, why don't we care about ourselves like this all the time, pregnant or not? So I'm really starting to like scrutinize every single thing that I consume and make sure that I feel good about it. Like, would I put this directly on my baby? Now that I'm growing a baby in my body after pregnancy, I probably won't use some of these products again because I cut them out now, and I feel like I should take the same care with myself, pregnant or not. So this has been just like a great reminder how important clean makeup is to me, particularly powders, all my powder products. So I use this Seal the Deal powder. Mine's almost gone, if you can see. All of my blushes, my bronzers, highlighters, everything is talc-free. And that's been really important to me, because what really freaked me out about talc was the Johnson & Johnson lawsuits that actually linked deaths and cancers to talc consumption, because in the mining process of talc, it's very easy to be contaminated with asbestos. And asbestos is a very toxic ingredient that can cause all sorts of health issues. issues, so I've just completely removed talc from everything. I just wanted to mention that because I think clean makeup has been something that has really been at the forefront of my mind. It was kind of like the last piece where I still had a lot of like favorites that I was still using that weren't clean, and I've completely cut them out during pregnancy and kind of relied on my own line and, you know, been more inspired to create some new products than ever before because I just really want to carry into post-pregnancy keeping up a completely clean makeup routine. I think we did it, guys. I think that's it. We made it through all of my pregnancy favorites. I hope that this was helpful, and I hope that you found one or two things that you might want to pick up that could be helpful for you. Congratulations if you are expecting. It's a really exciting time. And I just want to say a quick note to all of my pregnant moms out there. I know that this is such a weird time being pregnant in a pandemic. I know I've been pregnant all of 2020. I found out in December, and since then the world has just kind of gone nuts. And pregnancy is a really weird time of change, especially as a first-time mom. There's a lot of newness. You don't really know what to expect, and in an ever-changing world around you, you know, it can be very, very stressful to feel kind of a lot of instability in the world, all of these crazy circumstances out of our control, and then also managing the newness and change that comes along with pregnancy, the hormones, and preparing for this baby that's about to come. So I just wanted to let you guys know that you aren't alone. I get a lot of questions from you guys about how I stay positive, and I just want you to know that I don't always stay positive. It's definitely been a bummer, you know, to not be able to have my husband come to appointments with me and to have a lot of my appointments canceled and cancel both of our baby moons and not have a baby shower and all of these things. But I kind of just keep remembering the silver lining of this is that I've had so much time to be home and take care of myself and spend time with my family and slow down and reflect and nest and get ready for the baby. And there's not many times in life that you can do that. And just really the world pauses and gives you this opportunity to just like ground down. And I think there's no better time to do that than pregnancy. So in some ways, it's really not a terrible time to be pregnant. The other great thing is, normally, I would be home right now, 9 months pregnant, while all my friends were off on these fabulous vacations in tiny bikinis drinking rosé and posting about it, and I'd be having FOMO. But I don't, because nobody's traveling right now. So there's a few good things about it. And I think also leading into pregnancy, you know, like we would all be racing to get things done and finishing up work and traveling and, you know, checking off a bunch of boxes. But without that option, and like there's just no way to really do a lot of those things that we would be doing otherwise, it kind of forces you to slow down, which is really good for you, really good for your baby, and just gives you a time to reflect on what's important. So yeah, if you guys need any support, I'm always here. DM me, comment below. I want this to be a community where we can all support each other and share. So don't be afraid to reach out if you're having a hard time. It's definitely a weird time in the world, and being pregnant on top of it can definitely be a roller coaster of emotions. So yeah. Okay, well, I think that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a really great day wherever you are, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.